Assalamualaikum and good morning guys. So welcome to our first session of MIC and then I'm Ahmad Saufi, or you can call me Ahmad Ken Saufi from School of Information and Technology, Kata Bidang Teknologi. And here we have Mr. Ikram Al-Hafiz. Yeah, welcome to our show. So today's session we're gonna having like a talk about the security, right?
Yes. Okay.
So our topic today is gonna be security in creative media industry in Malaysia. So before we start our session, so I would like to introduce our speaker, which is Mr. Ikram. So he's from a lecturer from UPSI in Tanjung Malim. So and it's only in I think already done by Viva in the PhD, right?
Oh yeah. Thank you.
So congratulations. So without further ado, so can Mr. Ikram introduce yourself a little bit for the audience to get to know about you?
Yes, all right. So hello and good morning. Thank you, Mr. Kat Sophie. So I am Ikram Al-Hafiz. Then I currently working at UPSI, or stand for Universiti Pendidikan Sultan Idris. So as you know that USI is a teachers university, but in our department, so we are not trained a teacher. We are trained open industry players lah. So I'm an animation lecturer in the creative multimedia department, Faculty of Art, Computing and Creative Industry. So as well, I'm also involved as a comic and a cartoonist in several comic magazine in Malaysia. Also a new media artist and the latest one by following the trend. So I also do an NFT. So I can claim that I am an NFT artist. Mr. Kat mentioned earlier that thank God last month I just passed in Viva in my PhD studies. In augmented reality comics, looking from the point of view, aesthetic experience and user experience. So that's all for me.
Okay. So yeah, before we start our session, good morning, Getty. Okay, so before that, for those who just come in, just hit the share button, guys. So for the many watching, this is gonna be a great session of today output. So yeah, about our topic is about security. So every time we mention security, so about security of something like in the mall or something, security in the proposition of the items or something like that. So the first question that I'm gonna ask you is, what is the security creative media and who is using it?
Okay, it's a good question. Today we live in a digital environment, right? And use various types of creative media, from video, text, animation, graphics, motion graphics, multimedia technology, and the latest one, I think, the immersive media. That all that I mentioned is apply a creative content, right? You know. Furthermore, today as we are heading towards 4.0 industrial revolution, okay, so our digital frontier are increasingly open. As we know that the 9 pillars of IR 4.0, from 9 pillar is at least 5 or 6 pillar that are closely related to our field of creative media directly, such as augmented reality, Internet of Things, cybersecurity, the big data, and cloud computing. So this requires the large scale use of digital media, right? Distribution rests of ability to provide convenient use of digital media while equitably compensating all members of the information distribution chain, such as content creators, provider and consumer, right? So multimedia security is a field of research that stem from these needs. Then basically security in creative media is form of a content-based protection, right? It consists of the context of information creation, such as the form of video, creative content like design, animation, and motion. So in addition, in the context of transmission and storage, it's also involved in media security and content alerts that usually involve a higher level of data, right? So as discussed earlier, that our digital lifestyle today allow us to acquire, distribute, make media copies, and reduce distribution costs. The digital nature of information also more easily allows individuals to manipulate, right, duplicate or access media information outside of the term and condition agree in certain transaction, right? Say, we estimate content protection and right management and influential issue in context of delivery networks. Okay, the needs and issue in media security allow many studies, you know, to be done. I think I still remember that among them is the existence of digital right management, or DRM, that control the needs of a user right to content. All right. It includes the control the right of user to view, duplicate, access and distribute digital media. Okay, so among the main purpose of DRM, maybe is to balance the protection of information, the interaction of business models, legal policies and technologies. All right, so ideally, the ever-changing digital feature make digital right management or DRM something very challenging. Okay, so as a DRM solution, they use a Huffman code to protect digital media by introducing a new watermarking system. A watermark system, a technique with without compromising the quality of the media. So many other studies that use various methods in protecting digital media, such as a fingerprint, cryptography, stationography, and many more. In the context of creative media, this is the responsibility to everyone. This is our responsibility. This in it, right? So whether creator, user, distributor, manager, students, and educator to be together in the creative media security ecosystem to maintain a more beneficial environment. At the same time, government bodies such as MyIPO, which look after intellectual property or IP and the licensed creators to protect their creative work, such as literature, music, arts, film, sound, broadcast, and something like publishing, and many more. So, and this that's a good start for me. Thank you. And did I answer the question?
Okay, so basically it's more it's quite complicated on the first thing, right? So I hope on the introduction of security, I hope the students gonna be understand now.
Yes.
It's more important, right? Because right now just people are student or just another artist just post it in the Facebook, post it on without thinking about the security. Yeah. So when people like stealing off the artwork, yes. And gonna be a problem, right?
This is very sad.
Yeah.
So I just remember a previous month ago. So the issue in comics, issue in illustration industry.
Yes,
so so many yeah, younger generation still others works.
Yeah, so yes, I've seen also in this Facebook, in the current news, that
yes,
people tend to like stealing in the artwork and then print it into the
T-shirt.
I think that's more on, and then computing people either stealing or just copying, or just and then changing it a bit. That's why I just almost was like, okay, that's what happening right now. Okay, so the second question is, what is the important to use? What's important? I mean, what's the security media? Why is important?
Yeah, all right. I think Japan, right? Japan, Korea, Korean and Western countries import billion of dollars, you know, billion of dollars of creative media in the form of intellectual properties, IP. They do in film, animation, and music. So the presence of the creative media, the creative content is usually brought along with culture, food, and fashion. The strategy is something like this, you know. When creative content is we not only buy a show, right? But we follow their culture. We buy food, we buy their food. Okay, wear popular clothes and listen to their popular songs. So we can see a lot of Korean Japanese fast food in our complex. So we confound Japanese food, Korean food easily, right? We read comics in the webtoon.
Yes.
Okay. So I think webtoons, as many Korean artists do the webtoon, all right, and use a drawing equipment from Japan. You know, Copic marker, and then the papers on there, and then the software, you know, all right. So of course, this brand guarded and protected by security in creative media, all right. These intellectual properties or IP registered and become the economic activity of large digital media trade in the country that I mentioned earlier, right? Okay. So this intellectual property is the asset of the creators and is the asset of the nation as well, right? It can be a documentation for archiving, right? So archiving, we keep as a nation asset, or our intellectual property, right? Archiving various form of creative ideas, right? So archiving takes place on a tangible. An intangible basis of product.
Yeah.
Right. So, for example, you know, I said a Zapin dance, featuring a traditional costume, and traditional dance. All right. We can keep the costume, but how can we keep the dance?
Yeah.
Right. So the dance, maybe we can keep the dance with animations, with video. So that we call the intangible way. All right. Mm-hmm. To archiving the intangible way. Okay. If we produce with video or animation, we documenting the dance, it can be stored in the archive to become a cultural asset of our country. All right. They may be a creative innovation and on folklore and digital illustrate or redesign with reference to Malaysian story and culture. Right. It can be a creative product. It can be important for economic activity. Can also be referred to as an academic item, right? For research, for reference, for student, right? We got a lot of talent, right? We got a lot of talent. We got a lot of folklore stories, all right? We can use them to make an innovation or creative product. Okay, of course, this is important to be registered as an intellectual properties, so that it can be sold around the world and introduce our creative content and our culture, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, so it need to be registered as copyright and patent to prove that our work is original and protected under the copyright, the Copyright Act. I think if I'm not forgotten, Copyright Act 1987, right? Under my IPO. So I assume that the license today are creators and consumers. The listener, I said the listener today is a creator and consumer. Right? The student is also a creator to be, right?
Yes.
Yeah, creators in future. So and we must be careful in producing work by identify our reference source, whether in the form of full copyright, Creative Commons or public domain, right? Maybe as a graphic designer, for example, we use a lot of picture or illustration to produce our work. This is where the mistake happened with us taking picture without permissions, right? And we take and we be mistake when we get a picture without permission. So another example, when we take someone as soundtrack and you see the background music in our production video, right? So you know that only 5 bar in soundtrack in our editing timeline, so it is considered a thief. That we've stolen others IP, right?
Yes.
Okay. And it's and if we commercialize it, so action will be taken.
Yes.
Okay. Then the explosion of a pandemic, right? Open up space for digital error to be commit. All right. I want to touch the new market. The new market NFT art. Non-fungible token, which use cryptocurrency, which is so worldwide. It's so worldwide and has no borders. It's very closely related in the field of creative media. Okay, right? And the issue of media security is still being studied in this new market. Right? I remember previous weeks, last week, Hefan, artist, NFT artist, they make the fine art of Kluang Man, but the issue is the issue now settle with I think with a good manner, right? So the same goes for other platforms such as YouTube, TikTok, right?
Yes.
That give returns to the content we produce. So because of overproducing content, we forget that our content touch on sensitivity, take away the rights of others, right, and imitates the work of other that then difficulty with some case that occur do the content on YouTube and TikTok and so on, so many issues, that's the important things.
So basically if you got important like if you're having the artwork in the security, so it's merangsangkan people like do the original works rather than just stealing others artwork, right?
This is a different the huge different or massive huge different that we steal the artwork or we get the artwork for reference.
So that's why sometimes I was like asking my students to be as original as possible and then make it and reference as a reference. So that's the difference between taking design from reference and do the reference, something like that. Because just discussing about stealing things, right? So about the third question, okay. So when we talk about stolen media what happened if our creative media has been stolen or been stealing or something? Because I have been in the same place, okay, when I think last 3 years, I guess. I'm designing a Kad Raya for Hari Raya. And then I post it in the Facebook. Yeah. And then suddenly, my friend said, "Is it okay? Ni work kau kan?"
I think we.
So I saw somebody using my design to posting their Facebook post lah. So that's for, I think that's for more on minor or simple punya situation. He's been stolen at work. So let's say if he's been like stolen and being produced by shirt bagai semua tu. So what happened ataupun apa yang what we gonna do if our work has been stolen? MC Graf? Hello, MC Graf? Hello, MC Graf?
Hello.
I got a connection problem. Okay, no worries. Okay, so I repeat the question now. Okay, so like I said before, in the stolen artwork. Okay, so yeah, I also have been stole by another person from Facebook. So which is I posted a Kad Raya design. Wow. Kad Raya design in 2018, something like that. And then someone screenshot it and on me, and then says it, is it your artwork? Because I saw it in your Facebook. So, and then when I check into the person who stole my artwork, and then he using my work for the posting on the Facebook. So I think for me, I think okay, that's minor. Okay, for other people like maybe just post it in IG or Instagram or Facebook or something like in other media social. And then they saw it their design into the t-shirt, which is others production has been stole their design. So what's gonna happen and what he wanna do if that situation?
Okay. So feel sorry to hear that, Mr. Kat.
Yeah, no worries.
Something happened to you.
Yeah, I think it's pretty normal, I guess. Everyone has been stole, right? Okay. Yeah. So what happened? Yeah. What happened?
This question remind me of some case that happened lately. It is my connection lagging again.
Quite lagging. I think it's gonna be come and go. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's not good. Okay.
I don't know lah, because I fixed it yesterday. Right. Okay. So I just go with the question, right?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I think so. Now it's okay.
So I'm really. Okay. So this question thing remind me of some cases. Alright, have a illustrator has designed a cover for a magazine. The design and the illustration are quite beautiful and outstanding. Until a group of fans realized that the design was a theft of others' intellectual property, IP, that was only slightly changed to suit the concept of the magazine only, right? Mm-hmm. So, when we investigate, not the first time, but many times the artist has done the same thing, right? And the best part is, he got order from his work, so, and many netizen praise and support his work. Okay. So the netizen pun is also netizen is support and give full support. Then the attitude is not good lah, I think. Right. This is a violation of the integrity and unethical of the creator who take advantage the steal of the intellectual property of others. Right. This also caught the attention of a comic or Persatuan Pelukis Komik Malaysia, and warning has been done, you know. Right, warning has been made. Only it may now be gathering more evidence for action. Okay, I don't want to say the name. I think you know. Right. Okay. There are also other case such as an artist illustrate and designing an illustration. And the design is taken by others and made other products such as t-shirt. and book cover, and mark and the marks, eh? So if you remember a long time ago, right, there were people who who sold pen drive, eh? They sell, yeah, pen drive that contain animated video, Upin Edipin, Didi and Friend, yeah, Bobo, yeah, Boy, and it's widely sold on social media platform and on e-trading platform, you know.
Yeah,
it is very sad, because it is criminal act against the intellectual property of others. It should be note again that we are now in digital age, yeah, that has no border, and there's various way to steal or download or upload creative media, and it is very open to make a mistake. Okay, so what can I suggest here? If we realize that the potential of our work, regardless of a design, illustration, multimedia presentation, or whatever, please do a register the copyright first, right? To protect your IP. I think copyright is a start before going to patent or trademark. Okay. In the absence of official registration, it may acquire difficult to take action against intellectual property thief who constantly take advantage of the creative work of artists. Okay.
Yes.
However, I also understand that getting a copyright is not easy, and may involve some costs. So that's why artists tak nak buat lah copyright tu. So I think for a start, maybe the university and my IPO can have a discussion on how this can be made easier, right? To creators, your work may need extensive promotion on social media to attract buyer to your work, right?
Yeah.
So your creative work should also be on exhibition. So we have to exhibit our work. So to me, you might be able to use an appropriate watermark to protect, yeah, your work, right, from being stolen. If this also happen on and your work is not copyrighted, please discuss to the thief with the ethic well, or contact the relevant association, right, for advice and support for your work. So on the other hand, in Malaysia, we also have many creative association that act to help their member if a copyright infringement occur, right? Including comics for comics, and then we have Animas for Persatuan for Animasi Malaysia, Rega for graphic design and advertising, and many more, right? So so there are also special bodies that can be referred to, such as the National Art Gallery, MDEC, My IPO, FINAS, and many others. I think it's good start for you as a student or some creators to join the association of creative body to protect or to get support of your creative work.
So basically, if you want to do post some artwork, make sure you have a watermark before you post.
Yes.
So but because the last time when I was on the being stole that, I put my logo on the kad raya, and then still being stole. Macam I was like, what? So I was like, okay, no, never mind. It's been dah lama kan. So yeah, I just let it go lah. So okay, yeah, I think for other student or for other creators, should be put more clearer on watermark. So others stole your idea or stole your creative book lah.
Yes.
Okay.
Maybe your kad raya design is too powerful or too.
No lah. No lah.
So you can really use lah. It is beautiful lah. I think I want to share.
Yeah, so that's why I was like, wait, really? Okay, so before we go to the last question, is there any question for the audience to ask Mr. Ikram about anything about integrity or security? Anything, guys? No? Okay, so yeah, before on going to the last question, so here is Mr. Ikram, a lecturer from OOPSI. So we're talking about security in creative media, and I hope. Yeah. Yeah. So we have Fadi Vincent Amos. Okay. Yes, how about painting artwork? How about painting artwork? If some people try to copy other artists' artwork with all the formalistic, what is your opinion?
Okay. The painting is painting or sculpture or anything expressive. We call the expressive art. You know. So like the design or apa ni design animation, this is a commercial art or functional art. Okay, so when we go to the painting, we go to the painting sculpture or video arts, that's an expression art. So there's a body like National Art Gallery, there's always protect the IP of paintings. All right. So the painting is the fine art or the fine arts. The fine art part is more than a collectible item or collectors that we know an artist that do the painting. Right. We sometimes we buy a painting because the artist. We not buy the artwork. We don't know the artist, right? There's a different way and functional art and the expressive art. So in expressive art, yes, of course, we have in Malaysia, we have a National Art Gallery. We have a state art gallery that protect our work. So yes, a painting maybe have a $1 billion values, right? I think that's my question. So how about Faris? did I answer your question?
Okay, so I hope I think that's the opinion for Mr. Kla on the Faris question. Okay, so yeah. I think it's gonna be a bit similar on the creative media, which is in the digital world, with the painting, right?
Yeah, something for example that I do. You know Jai. Jaini Abu Hassan, the famous artist in Malaysia.
Yeah.
So maybe if I copy the Jai artwork or the Jai stroke, so the collector may know, right? So they must know that it's not Jai. So they want to buy. You think they want to buy my artwork that imitate the Jai stroke?
No.
I think no.
Yeah, no. Okay, so is there any question for the audience, from the audience? Any question yet? Yeah. No?
But a good question, Faris, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Always, thank you. Always support.
Okay, good morning, Su Amina. Okay, yeah, okay. All right, so now we go to the last question for the session, okay? About awareness. Okay, what is the best way to tell and to give the awareness towards younger generation about this, the importance of security in the media?
Okay. I think this is a over and over question. I like to mention again and again that today we are in the 4.0 industrial revolution. Yes. Okay. So right now, where the 5G connectivity explosion has no borders, no. Which streaming TV channels, e-commerce, the concept of data mining, and the new creative market with digital currency, begin to take over the previous market quite quickly, very massive. They go very massive, right? We will easily fall into the mismanagement of intellectual properties of our work. Will be easily to be stolen and used without responsibility. I think the government has always act authoritatively lah, right? Authoritative on this often on this issue. So it remain to be seen how to raise awareness to public about the importance of these intellectual properties being protected. Okay. First, I think the education must continue from the primary level to higher level, because education is that the directly capable of being knowledge passed on by mouth to mouth, right? And more people are educated, the greater the value of the awareness. So more people get educated. All right. Okay. So go to the second. Okay. Secondly, maybe we can intensify the campaigns again the need to protect the intellectual property. Maybe through animation or video or public service announcements, right? Yeah. So campaign can take place in maybe in competition of all age, okay?
Yeah.
And widely disseminated through social media, okay? We can make use fully utilize the social media, you know, because the younger generation right now very exposed and very close that to the social media. Right, the third one, maybe I want to social media to be widely used to inform about the intellectual property in the most creative way, right? Yeah. So that the message can be effective to society, especially the younger generation.
Yes.
So the younger generation is easily close to influencer, okay?
Yes.
Influencer, okay? And sometimes they themselves become an influencer.
Yeah.
Okay. The younger generation. So we need to be responsible for disseminating useful content.
Yep.
Certain party also need to use them to join, influence the younger generations about this creative media security awareness in this decade.
Yes.
And then finally, we as creators need to have a responsibility in producing original work and free of plagiarism, because
yes,
it starts from ourselves, right? Start from ourselves. Right, this is in it. Okay, the ethic integrity is in it. Okay,
yes.
Appreciation of creative work must always be continue, so
yes,
that it becomes something of great value, right?
Yep.
If we as creators do not value our work or the work of others, then a bad ecosystem will continue to grow.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So yeah. So that's for the. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Klang, for all the information that you give on this session. Okay. So before we end, thank you for inviting me. Okay. Yeah, wait. We have another question from okay. Late question. Late coming. Okay. Due to technology exposure, it has created another better point. In your opinion, how integrity can be part to secure the creative media industry? Sorry.
Okay. The previous discussion, we talk about the integrity. We talk about the integrity and the ethic is in our soul, right? So as a creators, as a consumer, and as a user, we have to perform our responsibility in order to use creative media, right?
Yeah.
Then the technology, we can stop the technology, and technology can grow massive rapidly. Then the ethic, but we can control the ethic. We can control the integrity. So that's why we have a four element that I mentioned earlier, about education, about the campaign, and so on. And then we have to semai them from the primary school until the high level of education. Yes. So that's my opinion. That's integrity. We can pupuk the integrity. Is it ethic in our soul?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So yes. Well, thank you for the opinion.
Yeah. Good question.
Yeah. Okay. So, say any question? So, like coming question? Any question? No. Yeah. Pupuk the awal betul. Start from. Okay.
You know, Mr. Kat. Did you involve in NFT?
I'm starting to like studying on the NFT. Okay, baru study last week. So maybe gonna join the NFT lah later.
Because I think now most student, creative student do the NFT and. I think banyak fan art so many fan art they use on NFT. I don't know about the security or about the act to use others work and then we just do fan art and sell in NFT. So why I told that the NFT is the creative security NFT is being studied.
Yeah, betul. Yeah,
good morning everyone. Bina Karim.
Yeah. So I think NFT is just a new thing, right? It's a new platform for people in creative media to sell their artwork, right? So I think and then still studying on the security because I saw like Luang Man in the fun animation Luang Man, right? So it's then an issue on that. So yeah. So anyone else for the question before we are ending our session?
Yeah.
Anyone else?
If a great short session, if it's a practical way.
Yeah. Okay. So I think
talk session.
Yeah. Okay. So I think there's no question left for the Mr. Ikram. So yeah, thank you, Mr. Ikram, for the information. Thank you for the knowledge that you shared for today. Okay. Thank you for everything that today. Okay.
Thank you for inviting me.
Yeah, so for other students for just watching this session, yeah, we are in MIC, we still have creative media in our school, which is School of Creative Media and Technology, and we have diploma in graphic design, diploma in multimedia and certificate in creative media. So we are interested. You can like learn in our way lah, in the MIC way lah.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. So thank you for coming. Thank you for joining us. So thank you, Mr. Kram, again. Thank you again. Okay.
Thank you for inviting me again.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay. So for others,
for listener.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for the audience. Okay, thank you. So yeah, take care, guys. So stay safe, and most of it, stay safe, guys. So and
bye.
Take care. Bye, guys. Assalamualaikum.
Okay, bye. Waalaikumsalam.